And so with that, I welcome Bishop Oscar Solis.
When I came here to become the Bishop of Salt Lake City, I was made aware that I have a territory that covers 85,000 square miles.
And so I would like to consider myself not only as a Roman bishop, but a roaming bishop.
And so I made it a point that I would like to immediately see and experience the churches that constitute the Diocese of Salt Lake City.
St. George Catholic Church, it is the last church in the South. We are approximately around 2,000, so we have a young community, Hispanic community, and retired community.
This is the first time, of course, Bishop Solis has been here in St. George.
You are confirming and solidifying your faith in Jesus.
It's wonderful to meet him and to see the care and love, and it helps to reinforce your life and faith.
I think the role of a bishop is to bring out the best in the parishioners throughout the diocese. And Bishop Solis does a wonderful job of that. I think we all aspire to present the joy of the gospel, but in Bishop Solis's case, he is presenting that joy constantly. It's just his nature.
We were hoping for a bishop and praying for a bishop for 22 months. And I do remember those masses that we offered for the bishop to come. So on the day we put the picture up and we told everybody that he was coming, it was a great joy.
El Obispo Solis, cuando vino a nuestra iglesia, nos hizo sentir muy especiales. Él es un obispo entregado a la comunidad latina.
He had a very heavy confirmation schedule when he first arrived. I can't tell you how much that meant to spend that time with the kids.
That's the most important thing. You know, it made a difference in your life.
Cuando vino a nuestra iglesia a celebrar la confirmación de los niños, fue una celebración muy motivada, habló muy bonito para los niños. Nos entusiasmó mucho tenerlo aquí en nuestra iglesia.
He's very approachable. He likes being called Señor Obispo by his faithful. I wish you were here every time because people are more reverent. So I don't have to make an effort to tell them to be quiet. But it's also because they are so attentive to his word. They want to take what he says from the gospel of Jesus Christ to their own life.
He is a sign of unity in the church. So when he is presiding, whatever he says, that's what matters.
I want them to feel that we are one, in spite of the distance that separates us. The Cathedral of Madeleine is the mother church for everybody. And so this cathedral is not just a monument. It is about the people. It is the people who believe in God and who put up their efforts and sacrifices in order to have a living testimony of God's presence. This is home for everybody. To celebrate our faith, our life, and our spirit of community.